I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Absolutely. Now, I got to ask you this. Everybody talks about Anthony Joshua. Of course, he has a fight in front of him. You never want to go past the fight because every fight is dangerous in that division. What do you think of Wilder Fury? Who wins that one? And do they fight Anthony Joshua?
Well, if the fight happens between Fury and Wilder,
I think it will happen.
I think it'll be announced.
Okay.
If they get in the ring, we'll see. Okay. But it's a great fight for Wilder. Great timing. You know, he's going to raise his profile. He's going to elevate his worth in the Anthony Joshua fight. He should win comfortably because Fury's nowhere near ready for this fight at the moment. And it's the perfect fight to build our fight. So people say to me, how do you feel about Fury against Wilder? I go, absolutely great. It's a brilliant fight for the division and it's a great fight for Anthony Joshua. So, but the main problem we're having at the moment is they don't want to talk to us. So we agreed terms. We sent them a contract. They just completely went cold on us, didn't even reply. They said they had their excuses. And then after that, we said, look, here's the contract again for the 13th of April. We've signed it now. So all you have to do is sign it. Then they said, we don't like the terms of the contract. They said this publicly, not to us. They didn't even reply to us. So last week, we sent an email saying, look, could you reply to us and tell us what you don't like about the terms that you've originally agreed to, because we want to make the April fight. And still no reply. So it's very frustrating, especially when you see fans say, oh, you're ducking the fire. If they won't talk to us, they refuse the meeting with me, they refuse to send a contract, now they won't reply. How do you make a fight? I mean,
you know the boxing game better than I do, because you're the highest level. But sometimes what happens, Eddie, there's a lot of miscommunication. And if you don't talk directly to the fighter, the people around may not.
Well, Shelley's made it clear he didn't agree with the deal. He thought it was a bad deal for Wilder. But they accepted the deal. But the problem is, I'm not going to encroach. I mean, I've reached out to Wilder and made him big offers. But people, one of the problems in boxing is people will poison people's brains, right? So what Shelley Finkel or Al Heyman or Jay Diaz is telling Deontay Wilder, we don't know. What people are telling Mikey Garcia, you know, people like Richard Schaefer, who would have a breakdown if Mikey Garcia signed for Matchroom. You imagine what those people are telling those guys. So that's what you have to deal with. You're not just dealing with trying to attract a fighter to the network. You're dealing with sometimes jealous people who are trying to poison the minds of fighters without letting them make their own minds up and their own decisions. So, you know, I've reached out to Wilder and said to him, look, these are the offers, can we get some feedback? And there is no feedback. So, listen, let him see if that fight happens with Fury, and we'll talk. But the problem for us is, and by the way, Joshua has a very tough fight against Povetkin.
Absolutely.
On September
22nd. Absolutely.
And anyone who knows boxing, he's saying, this is a war, by the way.
It is.
So he's got to come through that. But we got to move quickly after that fight because we'll get another mandatory put on us.
And you have to stay busy and you have to keep
Absolutely.
Selling. And he's a superstar. He shouldn't be sitting on a shelf being punished.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So it's all right. Life goes on. Got you.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.